Hey guys, welcome back to another amazing episode of Fame Central. So guys, in today's video, we are going to discuss what happened to Evanescence. Are you guys excited? Let's get started. So keep up with me till the end. Comment right below this video. Subscribe if you still haven't and turn on the post notification for more videos. Once upon a time, rock band collective Evanescence was among the most interesting things to happen in the 2000s. Hailing from Little Rock, Arkansas, the five-piece band rose to fame thanks to hit singles like Bring Me to Life and My Immortal from their debut album. It's a decade that brought a plethora of fun memories for many, with Amy Lee and company surely being in almost everyone's playlists. However, with that being said, it's been a while since Evanescence rocked a scene with the singles. Since then, the band has gone through several lineup changes, feuds with record labels, and dozens of other controversies. So what happened to the band, and what have they been up to now? Number 5. Why Evanescence disappeared. Evanescence was on the brink of a collapse back in 2013. Wind Up Records, the imprint they signed to a decade prior, issued a press release that they'd sold part of their artist's master recordings to Concord Bicycle Music. TMZ reported in 2014 that the lead singer, Amy Lee, announced war with her longtime label over money as they would held a whopping $1.5 million in unpaid royalties. Not soon after, the label released the band and they became independent artists. Evanescence then went into a self-enforced 5-year hiatus before making their comeback again. Number 4. Evanescence band changes. Over the decades, Evanescence had gone through several lineup changes. As a result, nothing from their 5 studio albums ever featured the same personnel. The band started off with Amy Lee and guitarist Ben Moody back in 1995, before enlisting David Hodges in 2000 and John LaCompe, Will Boyd, and Rocky Gray in 2003. Ben subsequently left the band in the same year due to creative disputes, and has been working on his solo efforts since then. Ironically, it was Amy and my absolute equal devotion to Evanescence that drove us to such extreme opposition. We had such opposing desires and personalities that mixed with the pride of youth and inexperience. He recalled about his sudden exit from Evanescence in an interview with Spin. Number 3. Amy Lee vs. Hacker Group Anonymous. Additionally, the lead crooner also faced several serious allegations from the anonymous hacker group back in 2012. Under an operation they called Operation Pedo Chat, the group of internet activists called her out and said that the singer and her manager Andrew Lurie had been shielding sexual offenders in a sick cover-up. As reported by NME, the accusations also included several disturbing and heavy claims like drugs offenses that have been expressly admitted by the alleged perpetrators, and sexual offenses against a physically disabled male minor, and cartoons with preteens and lawful poses with sexualized captions, including sexual activity with animals and one caption regarding a toddler consuming human feces. Number 2. Evanescence's latest album. With that being said, after years of hiatus and controversies, it seems like Evanescence has now erased from the ruins. Last year, they released their first album in more than 3 years, The Bitter Truth, and it ended up on many publications' year and must-listen album lists. It's Evanescence like never before, raw, candid, and heavily insightful. It just all fell together, Amy Lee told Rolling Stones. The heavier the music, the more it was in the Metallica Pantera world, the more similarities I could draw with Beck and Beethoven. Number 1. What's next for Evanescence? So, what's next for Evanescence? Under the new formation featuring Amy Lee, Troy McLawhorn, Jen Majura, Tim McCord, and Will Hunt, the rock band gets their third rebirth under The Bitter Truth. To further promote the album, the band is set to co-headline a European tour with the Dutch metal band Within Temptation, and they don't seem to show any sign of slowing down soon. I think I've learned yet again that the biggest challenges and the biggest pains in my life are usually what lead me to music, and it's hard to admit this, but what tend to make the best work for me? The singer explained her latest music to Loudwire. And for me personally, music has always been my therapy, my catharsis, the place to pour it out and spin it into something good that I can love and reflect on. So guys, this was all about today's video. Share as much as you can. That really motivates us to create more content for you guys. With this, we end our video.